All right, let's finish this. Fucking bastard. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so my situation here is, how do we, what's the root of the problem, and how do we solve it? Just taking people in and be like, hey, we're rich, you can come here.
Tim, we're sort of far afield here. I mean, you were telling me that...
So what Tim wants is for us to find the root of the problem and solve it. Oh, is that it? Oh, I hadn't thought of that.
Your parents aren't going to vote for the Democrats because we're taking in, we're giving undocumented immigrants... We're giving them health care.
Well, no.
And now what should we do for the Congo? I mean,
that's just hold on, full stop. So the issue actually was, I said the far left push. And one example, which we sort of veered off into, was immigration, borders, security, et cetera.
We can talk
about the far left stuff.
Let's do it.
Go back to that. So one example is the Green New Deal, right? Which is an identitarian, wish list.
A what?
Identitarian wish list.
Well, I'm not sure I understand what that means.
So the beyond the first page, everything was like race-based policies, right? Like, if you're of a certain race, you get access to certain things.
Give me an example of what you're talking about.
Reparations.
Okay.
So, like, did you read the Green New Deal?
It's hardly a new issue, that, though, is it?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure, Sam? Are you sure you read it? It's a whopping 14 pages long. Are you sure you could manage that one?
It's not about the environment at all.
It's partially about the environment, but it's about it's the Green New Deal. It's a
so
new
it was,
deal
it was college, also, jobs, healthcare.
Yeah.
So it actually barely addressed environmentalism at all.
Well,
and
no,
actually included
no,
race-based equity.
No, it calls for
getting rid of planes.
It doesn't say getting rid of planes.
A dramatic decrease in our carbon emissions.
Yeah, we're going to go back to ships, Tim. We're going to sail across the Atlantic, you fucking prat.
We're retrofitting
every building in the country. Does that sound reasonable?
Does it sound doable or reasonable?
Reasonable. To ask to retrofit every building.
America, fucking the land where anything's possible, apart from putting air conditioning in buildings.
To high-speed trains.
Fly thee not too close to the sun, O Icarus.
To bring about race-based equity policy, which is...
I don't know that we'll be able to achieve all of it, but yes, I think it's...
Don't dream. Don't. Don't try and achieve things.
Of jobs
don't make radical change. Simply not possible.
Prosperity.
Let me use a specific example of identitarian.
Yes, because that's going to be fucking useful, isn't it?
To tell you why my family particularly does not like the Green New Deal. So the exact example specifically in the Green New Deal references race-based economic equality, which is a reference to giving money to people based on their race. Do you think that I should not be allowed to go to college because of my race? I should be barred from a college because
no,
of my
you should
race.
Be barred because you're a fucking idiot. Is that a good enough reason? You should be barred purely on the basis that you're Tim Paul. I love the fact, this is the bit where he talks about his race. I'm going to be honest, I didn't know he was mixed race. And we amazed if how many. I wouldn't be surprised if many other people, including people who are fans of his, didn't know this. But that's not going to stop old Captain Identity Politics here. Fucking sitting, using this as an excuse.
Do I think that you should be
personally?
Barred?
Yes. So if I let's say I have a kid, do you think that?
Oh fucking! Can we not, please? Has the human race not suffered enough? Do we need you fucking get, is there a website for blind, deaf masochists that this fucking prat can get laid on?
Child should be
You can
not...
get a woman with a fucking a brothel with a fucking $100 bill sticking out your zipper, mate.
Not allowed to, let me try and make it clear. Should there be a higher standard for me, based on my race, to enter a university? Higher standard, not an average, a higher standard.
A higher standard. Well, I mean, I don't know what your race is, but I think if you're asking,
he's a Tim Pool. That's what he is. He's a Tim Pool.
Do I think that we should have, and of course, quotas are no longer allowed, but do I think that we should, higher education institutions should seek to have greater diversity? Yes.
So let me ask you, if based on the current existing policies, not on whether they should or should not be diverse, would you be willing to tell a child they are not allowed to go to a certain school because of the way they look?
Well, I don't think any child, any specific child, you would be able to tell.
His children, tell them that.
Is not allowed to go to a school. I mean, it's not a question
but
of being
the,
allowed.
But the policies are in effect right now.
Well, I mean, yes. In fact, I also have some bad news for you, that if you come from certain parts of the country, you are weighted, your admission into a college is either weighted positively or negatively. Are you aware of that?
Sure, but I'm talking about how someone looks, nothing else.
Oh, that's it. But judging people on where they're from, that's fine. If your kid looks like you, they've got a big enough fucking disadvantage in life, along with their genetics, and the poison you're going to fucking fill their brain up with before they even get to worrying about college, my friend.
Someone looks?
Yeah, just what they look like. Do you think it's fair to tell a kid, you look too much like that kid, therefore we're setting a higher standard for you?
Well, I don't think anybody would ever say that.
That's exactly what they did at Harvard.
That's actually not the case. It was found that was not the case. But
they won their lawsuit, that they are allowed to choose to put a higher SAT standard on Asians.
Yeah,
one of the smallest minorities in the country.
They're looking
specifically because immigrants are getting in those schools.
They are looking to create a student body that they want to be diverse.
Great, I appreciate that. So what you're telling me is I have to tell my kids.
No, Tim, when people, this is the thing about when people talk about diversity. No one has ever got hired for a job who wasn't qualified just because of their race. Everyone who gets hired for a job is qualified for that job. Now, there might be people who were more qualified, but that doesn't mean that the person who got the job was not qualified. You're not qualified to do the fucking job you do now, which is disseminate information to millions of people. Who, God bless them, look for you to as some sort of authority on this fucking matter. Yeah.
Lie on their application forms and make sure they don't know that you're part Korean.
Yes, for God's sake, if you're Tim Pool's kids, change your fucking name.
We have to lie about a race. Because when I was little, I was specifically
You still are little.
By my family that if I ever told any institution what my race really was, they would discriminate against me based on my race. So when I see Ocasio-Cortez create race equity policies as a wish list, I immediately recoil in horror. I want to make sure that when I apply somewhere, I don't have to lie. I don't have to tell my kids to lie. But that's the world that's being created by those policies. And that's what scares my family, especially my dad, who's white, who married into a mixed race family, who's specifically targeted because he's white. And he's passed over for jobs and promotions.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
And, you know, my dad's a good sport about it. He says, yeah, you know, life, you know, move on. And he did his thing and he had no qualms.
So your dad doesn't give a shit. He's done all right.
About it. And then I had to contend with the fact that simply because of the way I look.
You look like a fucking white bloke. Let's not pretend otherwise. Okay. I don't give a shit what your fucking ethnic background is. You look like a fucking white bloke. You don't look fucking... You don't look Asian. You don't look Korean. You look like a short, fat, bald white bloke. TheEnd.com.
So, I have to lie. I have to absolutely lie. I'm better off claiming I'm Hispanic than actually telling people...
No, just claim you're a white bloke. That's what you look like.
I am. It's a nightmare that I don't want to live in. And I'm
It's a nightmare. I don't want to live with this
because of these policies.
I can't live I can't live with the fucking with the horror of lying on an application form.
This, how would you address the legacy that we've created in this country for the African American community? We know that up
class.
Until, excuse me,
class-based class. Policy, right? So
I mean, there are
economic
there are
programs. People.
Their economic program, well, like economic programs, like what?
Like giving admission based on instead of saying like if you're Asian, you got to score 1440. We say if your income is below 30, then you have to score less. Or we say we will carve out a section of the school to guarantee low income arrivals.
I mean, I think that's actually, there are folks, Richard Collenberg comes to mind, who is attempting to sort of do that as a way of getting around the bars against sort of racial quotas. Because when it comes to the distribution of wealth in this country, it matches up quite, fairly efficient.
That's why I think class addresses everything.
Well, Tim, does class? Aren't you just swapping one division for another that ultimately is probably going to have the same impact? I mean, the amount of money you fucking earn, I can't believe you're classified. I can't believe you classify as lower middle class. You've got to be, you've got to have a couple of million at this point.
Well, I mean, I think I don't have a particular argument against that. I think that's one way to go about it. I mean, it's quite clear, though. I mean, you've already let the cat out of the bag that you think that to a certain extent it will provide for more equity for race. And I think you're going to run up against the same problems that the arguments against the Green New Deal are going to engender anyways. I mean,
so right now, at Harvard,
If you look at historically black universities, which is part of a program that at least a couple of the Democrats have proposed in providing more funds for those schools, it's because black people have been systemically shut out of the greatest wealth generator that is house ownership in this country.
Yeah, but do black people have to? A black person doesn't have to lie on their application form and claim they're Hispanic or Chinese or white, like this poor bastard has had to do. Yeah.
Since this country was founded. And so these colleges don't have the same opportunity to develop endowments. And so you give that money directly to these historically black universities. That's not class-based, but it is.
So here's the problem with race.
Here we go. That's a sentence that's going to end well, isn't it?
Harvard, for instance, has an influx of Chinese immigrants and Indian immigrants. That is checked off as Asian, but it completely ignores Laotians and Vietnamese and
Laotians! Oh, of course, the Laotians! Oh, the people of Laos! The poor people of Laos, all those fucking... The fucking... The waves of fucking Laotians who fucking come over from America. What about them, Sam? Did you think about the people from Laos? No, I don't think you fucking have, had you? Dear man, I'm there for the people of Laos. I'll tell you what. If you're from Laos, solidarity, brother.
Who have to lie and pretend to be something else because...
Well, it's a good job that white people can't tell the difference between any of them then, isn't it? Use our own ignorance against us.
I'm not going to defend Harvard's policy. I don't really...
Where are all these people from Laos and Vietnam who are lying on application forms and claiming they're fucking Chinese? Where is this? Where is this happening?
Just Harvard. It's across the board. Harvard is the recent lawsuit. But now you have affirmative action policies targeting race instead of class.
Well, you've always had affirmative action programs that targeted race. But where, what, right. what, Where are the Democrats calling for, you know, Harvard's admission policy?
I mean, AOC and other members of the squad have actively defended it and retweeted the ACLU, for instance, that openly...
They've retweeted someone. Well, fucking there you go. That's it. It's as good as law now, isn't it? They retweeted someone.
Well, I mean, you don't anticipate...
So they call for it. I mean, and
she... I mean, you voted for Trump. I mean, you voted for Trump. Did he have a great... What was his solution to this one?
Puts in the Green New Deal specific race-based equity, economic, you know, cap. I forgot what you called it. It was like racial and economic inequality or something. So the problem is, like, how do you tell someone that they're like, you're going to go to Will Smith's kids and be like, you poor kids, you need government benefits. I'm so sorry.
Oh, yeah, because that's going to happen. No, they're not going to do that, you fucking prat. Oh, God. Poor Will Smith's kids. I think if they did offer him benefits, expensive. They'd probably say, nah, thanks, I'm all right, cheers. I'm fucking loaded.
Well,
or do you look at those who are actually in need and say...
Yes, Tim, that's literally what you do. You don't start off with the fucking black people who are already multi-millionaires. You imbecile.
I'm not worried about that. Like, you know, like when Hillary Clinton said, I don't want Donald Trump's kids to get free college. I think that would be great. I think it would be great to have billionaire kids go to college with other people. I don't know that they would take them up on it. I don't know that Will Smith's kids would avail themselves of whatever opportunities the Green New Deal provides for them or not. But I'm not too worried about that. I mean, it's frankly... It's a massive, massive bill that is, trying to address climate change and inequity in our society, more broadly speaking, and to develop prosperity. And so, I think whatever floats your boat, but if that's what your parents are focused on, I would suggest that maybe they need to look at a broader picture.
I think... Everybody has certain, like, core issues.
Even the people from Laos, Sam, do they have to look at the people from Laos, the Laotians? Oh, you, fuck it, you're anti-Laos. Your anti-Laos bigotry really fucking just rubs me the wrong way, Sunbeam.
Their world is based on, right? And so, coming from a mixed-race family... You can imagine that's a huge deal, especially a poor one that we lost our house in bankruptcy and went through a divorce, and so we had a tough life.
You went through a divorce. Yeah, fucking, yeah. They had you.
And I was homeless several times. And then, me trying
Good.
To my way to the top, I get this really special kind of treatment as being part white and part Asian, is that they're both considered...
Yes, but no one knows you are until you point it out. No, you don't get any special treatment, mate. Right? Trust me. Right, when people think Tim Pool, they don't think, oh yeah, he's that part white. Tim Pool, a name synonymous with being part Asian. But no, you're not.
In a weird space. So there's active discrimination against Asians, and then there's, active discrimination against white people. Of course, now the current trend with
what a shitty shame you're both of them. So you get double trouble. If only that were the case. What you're saying is, Tim, is that despite the fact you make literally fuck it, despite the fact that you earn, doing what you do now has earned you literally hundreds of thousands of dollars a year, probably millions. Despite all of the money you earn now, are you saying that you've been held back? Think of how much you could be earning if it wasn't for the fact that you were part Asian.
Feminism is that white people, you can't be racist towards them. But tell that to the dude who's dying of opioids in the middle of the country because he lost his job 4 years ago, and he'll go vote for Donald Trump.
Well, I think the fact of the matter is that when we talk about discrimination, it is really a function, at least if you're going to look at it in terms of racial discrimination, in terms of power dynamics. And there is no doubt that systemically, African-American people have been, prevented as a community from developing wealth. And I mean, I think that...
I think it's worse than that. I think they were actively hindered.
Oh, yeah.
Well done, Tim. Give him a fucking biscuit. Well done, Tim. They were actively hindered, yes. Don't forget it. And the Laotians.
There's, you know, we can look at Ferguson. We can look at the story of the bombing of what they called Black Wall Street. Yeah, of course, man. My family had to flee state to state because of it was miscegenation was illegal, and I certainly didn't go through. It's an interesting conundrum, I'll admit, because I think for my family, it's hard to quantify who has it worse or better based on race. And this is the exact problem I have with race-based policy. Is it fair to say that the smallest minority in the country, mixed race people, have a monolithic experience? It's just not true. However, I also have zero community. There's no community I can turn to.
No, but you don't make policies based on specifics, Tim. You don't make policies based on every single individual's personal circumstances. You can't. It's impossible. You only make policies based on what statistically is the most fucking likely. That's it. That's how it has to be done. You can't sit there and go, oh, this person's got this thing, but they've had that. You can't make policies for each, you can't, it's just not possible. I'm sorry. That's why you want to keep going back. You're saying you can't make it, you can't make certain judgments. No, but you don't make only judgments based on race. You can make judgments based on class, on gender, on things like disability, on things like, things like mental illness, on things like, on sexuality. You can make these, it's a whole manner of shit, right? But if you agree that, African-Americans as a group have been hit, does that mean there are white people? Does that mean there are African-Americans or racial minorities who are not, who aren't better off than some white people? Of course there fucking are. Let me put it this way. If let's say all of your factors that are taken into account for privilege, let's say it was like a yearly subscription, like you have to, and let's say you had straight white cisgendered male, right? Let's say those are your four, right? You'd just click auto renew, wouldn't you? Would you change any of them? Would you rather wake up tomorrow a woman, or transgender, or gay, right, or black? I don't think you would.
I'm, at Occupy Wall Street, I was actively shunned from every group based on race. They told me you can't, white people aren't allowed, and so.
But Tim, you're part Asian. Could they not tell? Were they not able to say, hey, look, that geezer's clearly, 1/64th Laotian? No, they thought you were white. So your problem is, and were these people white too, Tim? Because I don't think you were shunned from Occupy Wall Street because you were white.
The white people would then tell me to go to the color. Like, I'm like, I don't even know what you're talking
about. The white people at Occupy told you to bugger off to the colored set. So they had segregation on Occupy. Fuck off. Bollocks, right? A, bollocks, right? And B, well, you don't need a B because the A was so fucking great.
Like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do to address.
Just fuck off, Tim. Maybe that was the overall message. Maybe they weren't telling you to fuck off to your section. Stop mixing with us. Maybe just to fuck off. Why is that? Because you're Tim Pool. I don't care whether you're black, brown, white, fucking green Martian, a member of the fucking Mickey Mouse to piss off, you fucking arsehole.
These issues, if you're basing everything off race and identity, because I don't have a community. So that makes me very...
Oh, poor Tim doesn't have a community. Poor Tim with his fucking doesn't have a community. Don't you have friends? What? So you don't connect with... Don't your several million subscribers count as something of a community, Tim? Or the people that don't any of the people who you work with count as a community? Don't any of those people count as a none of them? You don't have a community? I've never heard such shite in my life.
Sour on all of this push that we see, you know, because Bernie Sanders said white people don't know what it's like to be poor.
I love how everyone He clearly, right, I know what you're talking about, right, he clearly fucking misspoke. But I love how people will always take one thing someone says. They'll ignore the 99.999% of the other times when everything else they say. But they'll say that one little bit, you know. Where quite clearly the language they chose and the words they chose were poorly chosen. Right? But obviously, white people know what it's like to be poor, Tim. And Bernie Sanders knows that. Do you know who doesn't know? The cunt you voted for.
And that for me was like,
Bernie Sanders said white people don't know what it's like.
I look, Bernie Sanders says one thing, right? Think of everything Trump's fucking said. Doesn't fucking bother him one bit. Bernie Sanders says one thing. Do you know what that is, Tim? That's your fucking confirmation bias. That's you looking for something.
Or
he absolutely did.
In what context?
So on the debate stage in 2016, he said, if you're white, you don't know what it's like to be poor. You don't know what it's like to live in a ghetto. And
in a ghetto.
I don't know the full quote, but it was essentially it. Those are two key points he said.
I'm familiar with it. I'm surprised about that. I've never heard Bernie Sanders being accused of not appreciating poverty of all races.
Tim, is it not possible, though, Tim, that he just chose his words poorly? Is that not possible? Do you think Bernie Sanders has got some anti-white fucking agenda? God, I wouldn't be surprised if you think that now.
Conceivable he misspoke, but that is not, I think, consistent with everything else that we know about Bernie Sanders. But,
thank you.
Nevertheless, I mean, I think if you think that the left has a problem with race, Tim, wait till you find out.
Hey, fuck it! You're lucky enough to vote for him, though, didn't you?
Being on the right. And
so, in what capacity, though? Because you know, when I go and talk to like a Trump supporter, my race never comes up. I'm never asked about it.
Because you look like a white bloke, Tim. They think, oh look, a white bloke. That and the fact that if they're talking to you, they realise that you are serving their agenda. You are helping them. That's why, you fucking idiot.
When I go and talk to, you know, millennial leftist types, they tell me to shut up because I'm white.
I don't know.
You know what, Tim? I've been told to shut up because I'm white and because I'm a man and because of it. And do you know what I say to people who say that? Fuck you. Guess what? You don't have to do what these people tell you to, Sim. If someone tells you to shut up because of something, you know, like some aspect of yourself like that, guess what? You don't have to do it. You have every right to fucking sit there and say, no, I'm not going to shut up. And let's be honest, you fucking haven't, have you? No, it hasn't shut you up. Who cares what they fucking say?
About your interactions with different people. And I don't know if you know... You may not like the personalities of people who vote for leftists, but I'm really talking about policies. And
yeah, I'd rather a meritocratic policy.
Well, but there.
Oh, no, you don't, Tim. You do not. Tim, the last fucking thing on planet Earth that you fucking want is a meritocracy, my friend. You do not want to live in a fucking world where people's success and people's fucking achievements are boiled down solely to fucking merit. Because you, my friend, are fucked.
You know, the point is that how do you establish what a meritocracy is? I mean, because when you have certain segments of the population who have had much greater opportunities to develop what we assess as merit, right? I mean, how do you measure that? I mean, I can tell you that any person.
Oh, the free market. Yeah, that's a fucking good idea, isn't it?
I can tell you that any educator you talk to, when they're assessing the qualities of schools, the first thing they'll ask is, what is the median income in that area code? And I will tell you the quality of the schools there. And that is, you know, so we know that there's a huge deficit for people living in poverty for their kids who go to kindergarten in terms of like a listening vocabulary deficit. I mean, we know that you're living in a poor area, and particularly a minority area where minorities have had less political power, that your chances of growing up with air pollution are greater, and that has a direct effect on your neural pathways and your brain development, and can impact.
Jesus Christ, he must have been sucking on an exhaust pipe since the age of two.
Your behavior, new study out showing, you know, expanding on the work that people have done in terms of lead and what it's done in certain areas. So, you know, I don't know how you establish merit in the context of a society which has, you know, handicapped specific communities within that society. Well, how do you then assess a merit? How is that fair? How is that possible?
Well, no. You. So when I say meritocratic, I'm not throwing out any kind of government program at all. I'm saying we need class-based.
It doesn't matter whether you're throwing out a government program. A meritocracy is a mera-fucking-tocracy.
Programs, I guess. I don't know what to call it, but. If somebody is in an area, I don't care what their race is, I don't care what their gender.
Yeah, you might not care. Well, obviously you fucking do, because all you fucking talk about. But it doesn't matter whether you care, Tim. You don't make the fucking decisions. You ain't an example. You know that when people say, "Oh, I personally don't give a shit," well, bully for you. But unfortunately, that's not the world we live in, is it?
I don't care what their identity is. I care about the obstacles in front of them.
Well, why do these things are mutually exclusive? I mean, if you look
because,
at these,
because you have policies people, specifically saying, like, voter ID is racist, right? While ignoring the fact
voter
that...
voter ID is racist.
But why is it racist to ignore the fact that poor white people are in the same economic circumstance as a poor black person? How is that racist?
For voter ID?
Are you saying a poor white person is more likely to get an ID?
A poor white person is more likely to get an ID.
So you're saying black people... Why don't black people get IDs then?
Well, to a large extent, it has to do with the way that the systems are configured. I mean, you can go and look in the trials that found the voter ID to be race-based, that the numbers of African-Americans who will be disenfranchised when you introduce a voter ID. I mean, these are all the data and academic work has been done for you here, Tim. It's in the trial.
I think you're talking about voter blocks as opposed to individuals.
No. I'm talking about the number of people when you institute a voter ID in a state like Pennsylvania, let's say, or Wisconsin, the number of people who are disenfranchised, who don't have access, as found as evidence in the context of these cases, African Americans are disproportionately affected for a whole range of
reasons. Well, I mean, we can get into the voter ID thing, but my point was like,
well, you brought it up!
But the argument to me is, if you're going to tell two people, like,
nobody's telling two people anything.
No, right, so here's the problem. If you're going to tell me voter ID is racist, what you're saying, I think, bears little... Like, the solution is simple. We set up ID programs in those areas you're talking about.
Well done! Yes, but you didn't even know there was a problem, you fucking prat! And if we did try, but Tim, you're setting up a race-based policy. How could you possibly do that? You can't possibly do that. You've just sat there fucking moaning about it. And as soon as you realise that actually, oh, that's the problem, what's your first solution? Well, set up voter ID D programs in that area. Yes,
that's one way of doing it.
So then to ignore the fact, I didn't mean to specifically get into a voter ID thing.
What are you doing in Wisconsin? They're going around and actually trying to get people IDs in that system, but it's far more challenging because there's a lot less, DMVs in these areas.
Right. I didn't mean to ignite the voter ID thing because I understand what you're saying. But the point I was making.
Well, you clearly did it because you didn't know. Don't say you understood.
Often, when it comes to macro level politics, they assign a racial component to it, ignoring the plight of those who may be in the minority. So I understand that black people may be the most disenfranchised, but why do we never talk about the fact that poor...
the poor people from Laos! The people from Laos, Sam!
...and poor Hispanics and poor white people are affected in as families the exact same way.
Well,
I understand the voting block issue.
I think if you find in these cases that it is an issue, but the fact of the matter is that when you're talking about the legality of it, there is no laws in this country about disenfranchising people because they're poor. I mean, you can't have a poll tax. Certainly when that comes up, it becomes an issue. But this all goes back to Reconstruction and, frankly, a desire even after the Civil War to inhibit the ability of black people to vote. And if you look and see what happened with the Supreme Court in the wake of the Civil War and Reconstruction, and by the 1890s, the Supreme Court was saying that it was okay for states to institute things like literacy tests and poll taxes. And
this is basic shit.
But in St. Louis.
These southern states in particular were perfectly fine to disenfranchise poor white people as well as black people.
Right. I completely agree.
That was a bank shot. They were willing to lose poor whites' votes if they could make sure that they didn't allow black people to vote.
Absolutely. So that's why I think.
We have laws in this country.
That's why I think. Don't fucking make me laugh bitterly.
About racial discrimination, we don't have laws in this country about discriminating against people who are poor. But for in very narrow circumstances. And so when obviously you're aware that we have a long history of disenfranchising black people in this country and minorities, and when we're aware of a policy that has been put in place that has de facto, disparate outcomes for different races, that's why you hear that, because that is actually something that can help strike down that law.
But it won't actually solve the problem. It'll exacerbate it.
I don't know what that means.
It seems like the obvious solution is, hey, we've got a problem that primarily affects one race. Let's institute a racial policy targeting this group. Like, you're now codifying racial law.
You just told me that you had a problem with that.
Exactly. I do. Right. Yes, absolutely. So, but it is nuanced. I'm going to stress, right?
It's nuanced, for fuck's sake.
It's not black or white. It's an issue of some identitarian policy makes sense. Some, like, government identity makes sense, like civil rights, and a lot doesn't.
Civil rights makes sense. I guess.
So if we have poor people across the board, and we can solve the problem of all poor people, and it would primarily benefit those who have been historically disenfranchised.
Why
we
do
can
you think
avoid...
they're mutually exclusive?
Because if you tell, let's say you take a Vietnamese kid who's...
Oh, for fuck's sake, here we go again. With these fucking imaginary people.
...years old, and he's partially, bouncing between foster families.
Vietnamese foster kid, Sam. Do you know how many of them there are in America? A Vietnamese 12-year-old foster kid with a club foot... and cancer, and a crippled baby.
look him in the eye and tell him you're not allowed to go to Harvard because they just want to lock
him. What the fuck's this going to do with literally anything, Tim? Nothing you were talking about. Would you let this go?
They can exclude you based on your race.
You're aware that Harvard's policy is not a governmental policy.
I'm making an example of the institutionalization of race-based policy.
I'm asking
you. I'll give you a better example. Tell the 12-year-old, you know, kid whose mother's crack addicted, he's white.
Oh, he's crack addicted white kid and his Vietnamese 12-year-old fucking crippled baby club-footed friend walking around with their fucking their Siamese, you know, conjoined at the lips.
To be a police captain because he's going to be shot down based on his race.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
That literally happens. It happens all the time. Tell that white kid who grew up in the gutter.
I think if you're a 12-year-old, you know, a 12-year-old crack baby, you've got bigger issues on your plate than whether you're going to be chief of police in future. If you're a 12-year-old Vietnamese fucking foster kid with fucking bird flu, you've got bigger issues on your plate to sort out before you worry about whether or not you're going to get into Harvard. You cretin.
With a crack-addicted mom, you are not allowed to make it up the ranks of this country, of this particular institution in government, because we have instituted a policy that puts a higher standard on you because you look like them.
Yeah, as we know, we put a lot of high demands on the fucking, you know, on the you know, the bastard love children of fucking crack addicted single mums.
I mean, I can tell you that I know, having been in show business and you know, and having been you know, and also in the sort of, to the extent that I'm in you know, the news business as it is,
Bob's Burgers, you know, Sex in the Sea, that film with that bloke from fucking, you know, the geezer who did blackface, what was his name, C. Thomas Howe, yeah, that guy.
I'm completely aware of the fact that there are times where my voice is less relevant in a conversation because I'm a, you know, upper middle class white guy.
Upper middle class being the important part.
No.
Let me read you this quote. Quote: when you're white, you don't know what it's like to be living in a ghetto. You don't know what it's like to be poor.
You don't know what
it's like to be hassled when you walk down the street or you get dragged out of a car. That's what Bernie Sanders said on the debate in 2016.
Yeah, I think he probably misspoke about being poor. But I think those other things, I think to a large extent, I think are the case. I mean, we had, that was when Stop and Frisk was still very prominent. And the experience of black kids living in the city is radically different from white kids.
Did you grow up?
Of your wealth.
Did you grow up in a middle class family?
Yeah.
I think that's what is where your perspective on who is deserving of help or isn't comes from. Because I grew up in a lower class family and I was homeless several times. And
I'm so I got to sit
in the gutter with people of all races, and I got to get beaten by the cops and dragged out of my car.
Oh God, I would never have supported the police in my life until you said that. I'd have sponsored them right then and there. I'd be like, God, I joined in.
Had cops plant drugs on me and you know, infringe my rights all across the board.
Yes, they're fucking bastards, aren't they, Tim? No one's saying that people haven't other people haven't suffered. You don't get this, do you?
I learned that the one thing we had in common is that when
the fact is a fact, you are 2.5 times statistically more likely to get shot and killed by a policeman than a black person. That's a fact. The end. And that's an unfortunate one, but the end. Right? That's a fact. Does that mean that you won't get shot by a policeman unfairly? No, it doesn't.
Or you're trash, no matter what race you are. And so now growing up...
You are trash.
I'm not refuting that, but I mean, look, we can look at statistics. And look at statistics as to how many black kids in the city were subjected to stop and frisk as opposed to white kids.
And you're talking about poor neighborhoods where the New York City police would go into poor areas. And because of historical disenfranchisement...
And who lived in those poor areas, Tim? Mostly.
Those who had no power to fight back.
That's
right?
Correct.
But I'll tell you what, they weren't going to the Upper West Side and going to those executives who are black and raiding their homes and arresting them for stop and frisk. They don't go to the Upper West Side. They go to the...
So you haven't seen those videos where people, literally the police pull over. You haven't seen all those mobile phone videos or those fucking chest camera videos of American police pulling over black people in cars who turn out to be fucking people in high positions of power in local government, do you? You haven't seen those ones, have you?
For areas where no one can fight back. So listen, I grew up on the south side of Chicago, right across the
Chi-town!
White trash suburb, and we got it all day and night from the cops kicking our door in, pointing guns at us, planting drugs on us, because we couldn't do anything about it. So when you see the number, you're right. See, you're looking at the surface. I see the race. Now realize it's because, yes, historical disenfranchisement, but it affects people based on class. Because I'll tell you what, man.
Yes, but Tim, you're missing the point, you fucking
rich.
Idiot.
It doesn't matter what your race is.
You can't sit there and say looking at one statistic is just looking at the surface and then looking at another statistic is looking at, you know, you're both looking at one aspect. You know?
To an extent, it does. I get it, right? For sure, people are racist. But like,
are they really, Tim?
But I think there's a lot of black people who would tell you otherwise.
No, I agree. People are racist, and you'll deal with them.
I mean, I can tell you.
Damn,
for,
I just swear.
Here's a story that I
can't swear.
I've got to go shortly, but
right on, no, I appreciate it though.
I will.
We've got 15 minutes to go, don't we?
When I first started in my acting career, I was on a show that was mostly an all-black show, and I played a white character on the show. And I went with...
Oh, God, Tim actually laughed. Yeah.
A buddy of mine from the show, we were at his apartment in Hollywood, and we pulled into the underground garage, although there's a lot of those out there. And as soon as we pulled in, his buddy pulled in behind us, driving a Range Rover. That was
with rims!
At the time. And he's like, oh, thank God you were here, because I had to pull in, because I was getting followed by the cops again. He had been pulled over by the cops in the 2 months prior 7 times. He had called the police department to see if he could get a sticker saying that he owned the car, because he kept getting pulled over.
It's funny, isn't it, Tim?
The cop said, are you black? And he said, yes. And he said, nothing I can do. Now, I never had that experience. And he, I think, based upon his car versus mine, was doing better than me economically. Mm. And I mean, I think that is, that I think is an example of, not to diminish at all, the experience that you had. And I mean,
And racism is a serious issue in this country.
Right.
Especially. I agree with yours.
Yeah, it's become a real problem in America lately, isn't it, racism? Yeah.
It is a big problem.
An example of where you can be subjected to race, to racism, and not have it be a function of your class.
I agree completely.
And we have perfect examples in the Northwest Territory in the early mid-1800s. We had 10,000 very successful black free farmers, and these states all passed laws. They're successful now, right? I mean, they're doing well and passed laws that were specifically targeted to discriminate against them. We've seen that with different groups, throughout the history of the United States. None that were necessarily as durable as that.
Laos, don't forget Laos.
So I don't think there's a mutual exclusiveness to this. I think for the, I find me a politician outside of AOC who is more, and maybe a few others, who is more concerned about not just race, but also poverty issues and economic justice and environmental justice. And I will doff my cap to you, but I don't think you're gonna find them. Now, no politician is perfect, but the fact of the matter is we have two parties in this country, and you can say I'm not gonna choose either, but all you're doing is you're
You did though, didn't you, Tim? You found it in your heart and soul, didn't you?
just sitting on the sidelines. You're not participating in the democracy. The hardest choice in the world is to choose between two, the lesser of two evils.
Well, the fact is that
you can vote for somebody who has no chance of winning, but it's more or less the exact same act. You're just, might as well go out and fight the middle.
I'm supporting Tulsi. And
God, Tulsi Gabbard. Ron Paul with tits.
To a lesser extent, Andrew Yang. And so either one of them will get my vote.
But I'm talking about the general election. I mean,
I'm going to vote for either of them no matter what happens. Well, I might vote for myself. I'm more of a like a union collective bargaining type mentality in that we must stand up and strike against.
But once you cast your vote, you've got no power.
I agree with the idea of withholding your labor, but the fact is that Tim is that voting is not about.
Did you unionize? Did you fucking form a union with people who are voting third? But no, you didn't.
If you're at work and you had two managers and you were getting stiffed on pay, and one said, I'll cut your hours, but I'll give you better health care. And the other said, no, I'll give you the health care, but you got to work, you know, extra hours.
You don't get to vote, Tim. You don't vote for your manager at work, do you? And yes, you and the other staff can say, walk out and fucking have a strike. And more power to you. But that's not comparable to an election.
I can say no, give me what I want, right? Yeah. I'm not going to choose.
Withholding your labor against the capitalist class is a far different dynamic than wasting your vote. It just simply is.
Well, so I.
Wasting your
I
vote
mean,
is.
Like, well, hold on. Like, which Democrat would I vote for? You know what I mean?
The one who is the nominee.
Absolutely not. Biden? No way.
Not.
Let me think. Kamala Harris? No way. She locked up innocent people, man. And that's nuts.
Yeah, because you voted for Trump. He hasn't locked up anybody, apart from all those kids in cages. Yeah, at the border. Yeah, apart from those. Kids who will never see their... Kids who will be taken off their parents who they'll probably never see again. Yeah, apart from those.
Tulsi Gabbard. A major in the National Guard with real military experience, who is anti-war.
I'm not telling you who to vote for in the primary, but the fact of the matter is that if Kamala Harris does not win the nomination, she, writing her in is useless act.
Would you vote for Kamala Harris if she got the nomination?
I would vote against Donald Trump.
But Kamala Harris locked up innocent people.
I am aware of that. Donald Trump.
I mean...
Donald Trump. He has literally kidnapped children who will never be reunited with their parents.
Thank you.
They are in foster homes, and they will never be reunited.
Yeah, but are they Vietnamese in a foster home, and did they have a crack-addicted mum? I mean, these are the things that Tim cares about, you know. Tim only cares about about specific details of people's plight if they're people he's made up in his head.
I mean, there's an entirely more complicated issue.
Not really.
What I just told you is perfectly clear, and it's perfectly.
I gotta say, Kamala Harris willfully locking up innocent people and extending their prison sentences is very different from people entering the country illegally and whether or not Trump's enforcement crossed the line.
Children.
Okay, look.
Separating them from their parents, they will never see them again. The parents will never see the children.
Did Kamala Harris separate the people she locked up from their kids too?
No, she put the whole fucking family in prison with them, didn't she? Did she separate people from the... No, she put someone in prison and said, oh, your mum and dad can go in with you too. God forbid, I wouldn't want you to fucking... Jesus Christ, Tim.
Right, she's worse.
Permanently? No.
Well, yeah, she locked people up that were innocent and held them beyond their terms for cheap labor, separating them from their families. I would never vote for that.
Okay.
That's dangerously scary. Like, you know, for all the bad things Trump has done, you know, we can compare and quantify what's bad. I'm not going to vote for either of it, you know?
I understand. And you will feel like you have a clean conscience, but you will also be deluding yourself because you will have no impact on the future. And really, frankly... You know, like, I think that it's...
Tell the unions that.
It is, No, you're consolidating.
Yes, Sam, tell the unions. It's all on you now.
No. I'm talking about standing up and being that tree, regardless of the majority.
It's got nothing to do with an election, for fuck's sake. Got a fucking...
That's not the point I'm making. The point I'm making is... when you know you're facing defeat.
Why don't you tell the unions? You've got more fucking subscribers than he does.
Don't give in to immorality simply because it's...
Oh, like fuck you. I am not being lectured on giving in to immorality to you. You are not lecturing fucking me on fucking what minute second one, my friend. On giving in to morality. Jesus Christ Almighty. I will take me on my worst, most immoral fucking day than you at your best, my friend.
Less immoral. That doesn't make sense. How do you quantify evil or immorality? Amorality?
You know, 73 million voters.
My show with this question, then I gotta go because I'm supposed to go.
Yeah, sorry. I appreciate you being on for as long as you did, though. We did go a bit longer than I should.
He said to me, would you be in favor of more concentration camps or less concentration camps? So if you knew that you were voting for someone who was going to create, and they asked me this because I'm a Jew.
You're talking about Obama?
No, they're asking, they were...
Yes, Obama. Yeah, because obviously he created concentration camps, Tim, didn't he?
This is a hypothetical that a caller asked.
A hypothetical, Tim. You know those. It's literally the only evidence you've got.
Because I was Jewish. And they would say to me, they said to me, would you vote in favor of someone that you could be sure was going to create 10 concentration camps? Or would you vote for someone who would create 5 concentration camps?
Yeah, but you didn't, did you, Tim? You voted for the guy who did actually create concentration camps, didn't you?
Not vote. I would vote for someone who is going to create less concentration camps.
So you're willing to put your weight behind somebody who's going to make concentration camps?
Someone's going
to
win, Tim.
I'm willing to put my weight behind diminishing the number of concentration camps.
Don't have to like it.
Before you go, it's a really great point that I think may separate. It's utilitarianism versus deontologism.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Here he is with his word of the day fucking toilet paper.
You're quantifying versus I'm not. You see that? I'm not saying you're wrong. I'm saying your philosophical standard.
Yeah, I'm not saying you're wrong because you're not, obviously. Let's get that fucking straight. You know, I'm not going to argue on based on you're wrong.
It is the minimization of harm, and mine is more about the individual is the small... You know what I mean?
Democracy, Tim. An election, Tim. A democratic vote is not about the individual, though, Tim. That's what it literally... It's everyone. It's not about you. It's got nothing to do... It's not about what you fucking want. It's about everyone.
I'm curious about the second part of that. You said, you know what I mean, because I really don't.
The two philosophies
about feeling
violating the ethics of an individual is violating ethics regardless, and yours is minimization of harm is better. So utilitarian versus deontological. From my standpoint, committing one unethical act is a violation of principle and ethics that can't be crossed. But I will admit, there's not like a hard line.
What do you mean it can't be crossed? Yes, it can. Welcome to fucking politics, my friend. Sometimes you have to make decisions that you're not entirely comfortable with. It's what grown-ups do. I'm sorry.
I think that is silly.
That's Stephen Molyneux fucking shit.
I mean, I respect you, you know, but they're very strong philosophical positions held by most people.
Are they really? Well, fucking whoop-de-do.
Less suffering is better, and that I am willing to...
I will tell you something you won't like to hear.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. This is the moment. You've all been waiting for. This is where. Just watch how Tim just oblivious to the reaction. He just fucking doesn't sell it because he's not fucking. He thinks he's fucking got this there.
I'm willing to sell myself if that's the outcome.
But I'll tell you something you're not going to want to hear, and I admit it's I'll call it dickish. Utilitarianism is typically the villain in most movies.
I don't care.
Yeah, so for instance, like...
See right there? I don't care. Now, if you say something, if you're having a conversation or a debate or an argument, and you make a point, or you forward something, and they say, I don't care, you don't go, yeah, so, like, you don't carry on. Right? Who gives a shit? He doesn't care. He's got this smug little grin on his fucking... all over his Chevy Chase.
Like Thanos was utilitarian and Captain America was deontological.
I didn't.
So Thanos willing to reduce the suffering by killing, you know, hundreds of trillions versus the, you know, thousands of trillions, which would be living better off. So,
but I'm not,
it's like comic book movies.
I'm not having to kill anybody. I'm just voting and choosing.
I mean, if you vote in favor of somebody who's going to build a concentration camp, you are.
No, one of these people is going to win, Tim. One of these two outcomes
stand
are going
in the resistance.
I can do that after I try.
Tim, look at the fact. I hate this fucking idea. Oh, like, well, not with that attitude. No, it's a fact. You're not going to get 95 to 98% of the people who vote are going to vote red or blue. That's a fact. You are not going to convince a significant number of any of those, of any of that, that's fucking. Of anyone in that 98% to fucking to stand the resistance. What you're going to convince at best is a load of people to not is a small amount of people, but significant enough that it makes sense to not vote for someone who's going to win, thus losing them. That's what happens. It's what always happens. And don't give me some bollocks example from 300 fucking years ago where some third party fucking, that was different. This is now. Okay.
And minimize what I'm going to be having to resist.
The concentration camp only gets built if enough people like you believe they should support this person in fear.
I got two choices. If 95% of the people don't vote, it's still going to get built.
That's actually not true. We have rules for that.
But
they're going to vote, Tim, aren't they? Yes, but 95% of the people are not going to not vote. In fact, fucking very much not this year. Yeah. How many concentration camps did you vote for this year?
That I heard from folks who were saying that they wouldn't vote for Hillary Clinton over Donald Trump was, we're going to teach the Democrats a lesson. And they're going to
vote. That was a decent amount. That was the 12 to 18%.
They cannot take our vote for granted. And
those are the Bernie or bust people, though.
Do you think that that lesson was learned?
No way.
No, of course not. And you know what? I said, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
But they voted for Trump. You know, you see the point? Like,
by not voting, they voted for Trump. Yes.
For me, it's simple. It's not one or the other. You're not either a utilitarian or deontologist.
Oh, thank God for that, because I'm fucking... You're not Thanos or Captain America. Oh, really? There's some fucking in-between. Is there...
Those are your philosophical things. I'm telling you.
They're just standard philosophies, but the point I'm making is...
One of two people will win the election. It'll either be Donald Trump...
Only because of that mentality, man.
No!
It's because of the system that we have.
It's because you put confidence in that system, and I don't.
Yes, it's your fault, Sam.
And if you didn't either, man...
Yes, he didn't put confidence in it, did he, you fucking wanker?
How many people would vote for somebody else? And change things. It's like this.
Maybe,
if everyone in a company stood up and walked out, they get what they want.
It's a company. A strike is not the same as a fucking election. How can you not know this? Why is this so difficult?
But you know what, Tim? You and I are not going to convince those people to walk out.
I disagree.
Well. Who was right?
Well, it's like this. I'll put it this way. The way I see it is an analogy. I understand labor is...
The way I see it, you've got glasses.
But I'm imagining being in a workplace and having someone say you'll never...
Oh, for fuck's sake, this is the 17th time.
Up in strike, so why do it? Just take the small raise.
You are...
Sam, get out.
The analogies that you are making are not the same. They're not doing the...
He doesn't get it, Sam. He'll never get it. He's a fucking idiot. You know that. I know that. Now bail.
20-foot, 20-story building or a 5-story building. You have 20. No choice. Okay.
You're going to die either way. Make it quick, right?
God, that was bleak, wasn't it?
And vote for Trump.
No, but people did. That was literally what people thought.
I've got to push somebody off a 20-story building or a 5-story building.
Oh, if it's him, fucking hell. Christ, there'll be a queue of fucking... God, it'll start in the next fucking hemisphere.
Because it's not me who's going to suffer. It may not be you if there's any difference between... If there's no difference between...
Oh, if there was a vote that made Tim Pool suffer, specifically him.
Yeah, he should not be in the race.
And Donald Trump. It's not going to be me or you who are going to suffer. It's going to be other people. People who are far more vulnerable than we are. Maybe your mom might suffer.
I'm not gonna ever vote for anybody in support of a concentration camp or any other very dangerous policy.
You're not gonna vote protest against to minimize them. The number of concentration camps is really what you're saying.
Because I'm gonna vote for the person who says no concentration camps.
What? But there isn't a person who says that.
I think Tulsi Gabbard is.
But she's not going to fucking win!
Not perfect, you know, but she's one of the best I've seen in a long time. I'm hoping.
That's a tragic fucking state of affairs. That's a fucking indictment.
I mean, you're pretending that there's a third option, and there isn't, Tim. This is not the way our system works. But listen, I gotta go. I'm sorry.
Right on, man. Hey, thanks. Let's try and do it again.
Oh, thank fuck for that. It's over. Jesus Christ. I'm so glad. Thank you very much for watching. My name's Dick Coughlin. I'm going to go stick my head in the fucking oven. Bye-bye.